Hey, folks, this is Jared McDonald here, and I'll just say something. Yes, I've decided to make a Booktube channel, and I've seen some Booktubers saying that Booktube can be problematic and can be very toxic. There's a lot of gatekeeping and a lot of elitism in the book. A lot of sources say a lot of toxic people in BookTube. I'll rephrase that. I've been hearing there's quite a good bit of toxic people in the BookTube community. Now, I'll make it perfectly clear. Every community has some form of toxic people in it. Okay, not every community is perfect. Okay, I can say I am a huge metalhead. Yeah, I love heavy metal, hard rock and heavy metal are my favorite genres of music. Guess what? There are toxic, a lot of toxic people in that community. Okay, okay. I'm thinking book, and also, I don't think BookTube is, any of is, I don't think BookTube is the exception. Okay, because guess what, BookTube, there's probably a lot of good people in BookTube, and a lot of bad people in BookTube. Okay, and the toxic ones are to me the ones that will try to cancel a book or an author all because they have political views or opinions on a certain topic that does not 100% align with theirs. Like, I consider you BookTubers that tried to, let's say they're going to stop buying J.K. Rowling's books because they think she's transphobic. Now, whether you support the trans community or not, me personally, I don't think she's transphobic because, and by the way, I'm not worried about getting canceled because I am a nobody, by the way. So, and they want to ban me, whatever, go ahead. First of all, I don't think you can ban somebody who, ban somebody because they have a, I don't think J.K. Rowling is transphobic. Okay. And the reason why, because stuff she said was factual. I'm like, it is. Let's be honest, it was 100% factual. Okay. And some of these YouTube BookTubers that I come across saying I am no longer supporting J.K. Rowling because she's transphobic. Okay, first of all, instead of having a discussion and hearing her point of view on transgenders, yeah, let's just cancel her because I don't like her opinions. I'm like, that's stupid, and you come across as very arrogant. You do that. A lot of the authors I like, I don't agree with their politics. I don't agree with Frank Miller. I don't agree with his politics. If you read The Dark Knight Returns, it obviously has an anti-Republican message in it. Okay? It definitely is very clear that he does not like Ronald Reagan in that book. But It's just very clear that he don't like Republicans, period. If you read that book. But I can still read it because, A, it's very well written, and two, it's escapism, it's not real. Okay, and a lot of these BookTubers, they want to cancel a certain author because of their past or what they said. You realize that fictional books like Harry Potter, H.P. Lovecraft's books, mean stories, whatever controversial author you can think of who write fictional storylines, you gotta realize that these books are escapism, they're not real, okay? Fictional books, like I've been reading right now, called The Russian Account. It's fictional, it's entertainment. I also been reading classical mythology by H.A. Gruber, that accounts by Stephen Koons. By the way, and I recently picked up a horror comic or graphic novel, whatever you want to call it. It technically gets a trade, but I'm just gonna call it a graphic novel for sake of argument. Dead Day, which is a zombie horror comic. Because all three of these books have in common are they're fictional, they're not real, they're escapism, they're meant to entertain. I don't care if an author has political opinions that don't 100% align with mine. I read books to be, I read non-fictional books, not non-fictional, I mean fictional books to be entertained. I'm currently rereading Identity Crisis, which is one of my favorite books of all time, one of my favorite graphic novels of all time. One of the villains rapes Dr. Light, rapes elongated man's wife, Ralph Dibny, who is Sue Dibny. He rapes her. He rapes her. Okay. In the beginning of the book, she gets murdered, and Ralph Dibny goes after Dr. Light because he thinks Dr. Light is responsible for the murder of his wife because what happened to her in the past. Okay, does that mean I support rape? Of course not, because I don't. But at the same time, Identity Crisis is a work of fiction. It's fictional. Okay. Now, I just, to me, these BookTubers, the ones that come across as, once the author is problematic, you think about it, they're the ones being problematic because they don't want to have this discussion. They just want to just assume a certain author is bad, or they want to cancel a certain author, a certain dead author, what they said 100 years ago. I'm like, now I'm not saying all of you BookTubers are like this. Yes, there are good BookTubers, and there's also good people in BookTube, and there's also bad people in BookTube. Like I said, every community has some has some has every community has toxic people in it. The metalhead community has toxic people. People in the comic book community has there's toxic people in the comic book community, and it's just really baffling to me that people who go around preaching about authors being problematic are the ones being problematic. And also, I noticed that some BookTubers I have noticed that that has become a vanity project. Like, they want to show off, like, yeah, it clearly has become I want to say a vanity project, or should I say more of a popularity contest, like, even want to say a popularity contest, I would just say it's a reading competition, like, who can read the most books in a month, and I'm not going to participate in that. I'm just going to read at my own pace. And at my own time. I'm not going to try to compete whatever BookTuber is doing. I don't need to show off. Show off a big bookshelf just to prove anything that I like to read. I'm not going to do that. And guess what? I am not a professional. Okay. And guess what? There's nothing wrong with a video being amateur. There's nothing wrong with having an amateurish video like this. Okay, not every YouTube video needs to have high production value. Okay. Yes. You'll probably get more views or more subscribers if your video has somewhat of a high production value, but to me personally, just because you have a high production value doesn't mean your videos are genuine. So there's that, and that's all I got to say. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget to rate and subscribe, and see you guys later. Bye.